Below the Bosporus, I made her my proposal with a guitar music, with all the lights, and she had to say yes, no option. And so really, Turkey is one of my favorites.
I will cut this part most probably during the video editing, but
No worries.
no, no, not your part, my part. For example, we have this one. This is
except when you drive the car and something hit you from the right or from the left, maybe that one.
Dear Jürgen, thanks for joining Faces from Places. Finally, long time after, we could get together. So could you please tell us about yourself?
Of course. Thanks, Murat, for the invite. And I really like the idea of the Faces from Places. Just a brief introduction. So Jürgen Hackel. So I studied electronic engineering and microelectronic. And I am in the healthcare industries above 26 years in different roles. I'm a father of two kids. A small son and a six-year-old daughter, really proud of, and I'm living in Austria and Salzburg, and yeah, I'm doing jobs in the sales segment, sales leadership in IT.
How have you decided to move to this industry?
As I'm from the school education point of view, I'm always interested in new gadgets and digitalization, and I see the world is going digital in all aspects. From the private life, but up also for the business life. The data management also was a big motivation. The data is growing, analyzing data, using algorithms. So this is a kind of hobby and business for me. And so that's why my interest is quite high in digitalization and also robotics technologies, by the way.
So what are the fun facts and difficulties about your job?
I would start with the difficulties because currently I'm within Stryker. This is a global company for joint replacement for knees and hip implants. And this is a very conservative market where the implants are manually prepared and implanted to the patients. And the robotics technology here brings a huge benefit. It's a kind of new level up in this industry because you have more data available in the pre-operational planning. You can also add the planning to the right patient. And so the implant will fit more accurate. And so the patient outcome improves a lot.
Is your profession specifically about the knee implants?
It's mainly the knee and the hip implants. Mm-hmm. And the robotic system is a robotic assisted arm and the solution from Stryker. And this I'm really interested in because it combines the digitalization part plus the manual part.
So this is the difficult part, right? So because you need to be very precise. There is no room for any mistake. And we are talking about the human body, human life. So
exactly. Exactly. Murat. And especially when you reduce something from the bone, you're not able to bring it back. So you have to pre-plan it very accurately. And so that the CT technology helps a lot here, but also the three-dimensional view on the bone. And then you fit the implant correctly to the patient, and the patient has a lot of possibilities, have a better move than in the past. As you said, in the past, maybe the challenges were the expectation of an implant was that the implant should remove your pain and should survive, the implant should survive. But now the patients, we do sports, we live longer, we have different expectations on the implant. So even after the joint replacement, you can do sports, you can play tennis, play golf, go skiing, and this is really the exciting part of this.
Actually, the fun part and the difficult part is merged together, right? So
it's both. Yeah, if you have fun if you do it via robotics, you have no fun anymore when you do it manually. No, it's not just it's critical, but we see especially this I would say it's very conservative joint replacement way of business is also going digital. So this was more the core message. And for me, it was a really big changing to Stryker because I am now in front of the patient. I never was such a close to a patient during the operation. And you see the bones, you see the ligaments, you see all the blood. Was a kind of scared at the beginning to see such patients so close. But it's very much exciting because you see then the outcome when the patient is able to walk the next day, and this is really cool.
Direct outcome to the patients. You are a very experienced leader, and also you work with the regional teams throughout your journey. Do you have any memory that you never forget?
And I never forget the moment in India when I visited India. I'm always a person, I like to see it up front, not just theoretically. I want to see it practically, how a hospital looks like. And my experience was I looked for the best public hospitals in India, and I was really shocked. I see patients lying on the main road, waiting for treatments, long time. I came with a suit. I like to make pictures of the environment. I couldn't take any picture, but the picture is always in my mind. And then I said, no, I want to do something in my life which contributes to improve healthcare all over the world. And the digital technology is an enabler to give everyone in the world a kind of accurate treatment and access to healthcare. I visited many countries, but that was a moment I was scared and happy, because after that, I had a totally different mindset when I came back home.
Definitely. I shared the same feeling. I will cut this part most probably during the video editing, but I was... Not your part, my part.
And also, this was a motivation for me to start an initiative, because as I traveled 24 years for this for AESO, all over the places from Latin America, Asia, Europe, I have seen the gap, but I met a lot of doctors and a lot of experts. And I said, let's bring all this expertise together, because everyone is an expert in his own field. So I connected all of them and created a nonprofit, a group of networking called Supporters Vision, and also to improve standards in healthcare.
How was it called?
Supporters Vision. And this was a group I really initiated after that. And it was also nice to hear, similar to your faces from places, I recorded their messages to the world, so how they would improve healthcare from their expertise point of view.
What about you? Do you have some routines? You start the day, you finish the day, what you do throughout the day?
Yeah, I'm working very digital and structured. For me, most important really in the morning is my first coffee. Without having the first coffee, it's a terrible. But after I have the coffee, I would start. I'm an early starter. 7:30 in the morning, and I catch up my emails, I structure the priorities, but for me most important is at the end of the day also having the time secured for the family. This is my daily routine: secure the time for the family, start earlier in the morning, be structured, and try to finish at the end of the day mostly the priorities and start the next day.
How do you keep yourself up to date?
It's the funny part. When I was in school, I really hate reading books. I'm more the visual person, watching a video and see YouTube and understand, let's say, roughly what is this topic about. And also, in addition, I read very selected books, mainly in the planes. I have plenty of time.
That's the maybe few benefits of traveling a lot. You have a lot of personal time. And in the plane, you can do anything else. So you have free time, no distraction, and you focus. I want to show you something. Okay.
Wow. That's a nice one. Even in the background.
Brand new. So.
Ah, that's a cool, eh?
So these are the books that they advised. Okay.
Cool. I see from Ekaterina from Moscow. Maybe this was the one, the Amor towels.
The gentleman from Moscow is an advice from Juliana from Colombia, Mehdi from Algeria. I think also this is Juliana, Tony from Kenya. Knowing you personally, you are very interested in new technologies, emerging technologies. Do you have some good catches from the industry?
Yeah, but currently, as I told you, I'm in the robotics field, quite interesting, surgical robots. And I visited an Austrian company, quite nice, in Tyrol. They have a spine robot developed with an augmented reality glass, with a microscope where the surgeon can really operate hands-free. And he controls with his eyes all the zoom and where he looks at. For the surgery. So this is a BHS International is the name of the company, and the product is robotic scope. Really cool. Totally away from my business direction, I'm in friendship with a CEO of a triathlon bike manufacturer in Austria. He's an amazing person, have a company 10 years now, and he make customized solutions, custom fit bikes for the special triathlete. And he every year he challenged himself to do something special.
Custom fit bikes.
Yes, correctly fit. He also make, when you drink, when you are sitting in the triathlon, you're not able to move because of the airflow. You should keep your position, not to lose time. And he developed amazing solutions on the shifting and on the drink aspect. and also on the carbon, on the material, but he's an extreme designer. So there is never a bike similar to the other one. And this is really amazing. It's a very niche. And sometimes I help him when we chat about what can we can do in the business development, because he's a technician, poor technician, and he's not a marketing guy. And so I'm helping him on the marketing side, having the right focus, and he's occupied by developing. There was a company really impressed me because it was a startup, extremely fast growing, called Smart Reporting. They have created templates for radiologists and using AI algorithms to make data in the right format. And it's also quite nice because when I met them, I think they had around 7 to 10 people. And now they have around 100 or even above in a very short time frame. And I see this is really fast growing and they are very innovative.
Could you please share about some cultural habits, what you like about Austria?
I'm really proud and very proud Austrian, and because we have this nice scenery, we have lakes, mountains, we can drink the water. I'm really proud of this. We have a very big culture. I'm looking in countries with history, so I'm also proud of Istanbul because this is my favorite place when I made my engagement proposal to my wife below the Bosporus Bridge.
You cannot pass this part very fast. Could you please give us?
Yeah, this it was funny. It was thanks to my friends in Turkey. I was often in Turkey, and what I like, in especially Istanbul, you have this Asian part and this European part. And I'm born as a European and worked 24 years for a Japanese company. Even I spoke a bit Japanese by that time, and I said, This fits to me, yeah. And when I saw the beauty of the lights on the Bosporus, the mosque, the Blue Mosque, and all the nice places, my friend recommended me, if you want to do something special, bring your wife here for vacation and make her a big surprise and a boat tour on the river. And then below the Bosporus, I made her my proposal with a guitar music, with all the lights, and she had to say yes, no option. And so really, Turkey is one of my favorites. And Murat, I love the people, it's the mindset, it's the positiveness, the culture. When I walked through the 100 years or even above old bazaar, huge, and the food, I will grow by size. When I go to Istanbul, you cannot escape from the food. So it really is one of my favorite all over the world.
Really, it's
and
a
really cool one.
Pleasure and honor to hear this from you. So what about Austria? Right. Do you use some gestures? For example, do you have this one? This
is except when you drive the car and something hit you from the right or from the left, maybe that one. But I would say what we like is when something is really cool, we put the thumb up. Or we give a smile. Once I read this book from the Red Bull story, and Dietrich Mateschitz, he was a globetrotter like you and me, Murat, and traveling around the world, sleeping in different hotels, and he was around 40 years old. And then, of course, we always go to the bar, right, in the evening, because when we are alone in a hotel, you want to find some social communication, and this good is always at the bar place. And when he wrote this story, he was at the bar and chatting with someone from Thailand, and they discussed about energy drinks and what they are doing. And by that time, he was a marketing guy from Unilever, from the toothpaste. Mm-hmm. And he said, I don't want to do this for my rest of my life. And he was a very creative person on the marketing side. And with this conversation, his whole life changed. Because he found out, I take this energy idea into the world outside Thailand. And he became a kind of family member of this group. And then he started to create a branding and everything. And what I really like is he took a huge risk, but he believed in this idea. He strongly believed in this idea. And he was close also financially to get bankrupt. But at the very last stage, it went up.
Yes.
And nowadays, this is a huge imperium. This guy never changed. You never find him in a clothes like a suit. Mm-hmm. You always see him in a jeans or in a leather jacket, or you see very rare that he gives interviews. And this impressed me quite a lot because he's showing his talent by results. and not showing it by words or by hot bubbles or storytelling, because he is the story. If you believe in whatever you do, you reach the goal.
What is your most favorite proverb?
Aufgeben gibst du nur einen Brief. Das,
what does this mean? You never give up, you just put a letter.
So the people says, if you give up, the only thing you give up in your life is the letter you put to the post box.
Okay,
but got it. Nothing else.
Ich kann Deutsch sprechen auch.
Perfekt.
Wie kann man sagt in Deutsch oder Austrian goodbye?
We said Servus.
Servus.
Servus could be for welcome and bye-bye, could be both. And the place I live in Salzburg, we are close to the Bavarian area, we say Vierti, a kind of bye-bye in a typical Austrian language. We don't say Tschüss as our German neighbors. We say Servus or Vierti.
Vielen Dank, Jürgen. It's always a pleasure to talk with you. So looking forward to our next touch base, and thanks for sharing your vision and knowledge with our followers. I wish you success in your business.
Really, by heart, thanks for the invitation. It's a big honor for me talking to you.
My pleasure. Take care.
Thank you, Matt. Take care. Servus.